Blackstone Audio presents Hong Kong Black, a Nick Foley thriller by Alex Ryan. This book is read by MacLeod Andrews. Prologue. The Necropolis of Qin Shi Huang. Shenyang, capital of China, state of Qin. 213 BC. Unification and punishment. These were the things that kept Li Su awake at night. As chancellor and principal advisor to Qin Shi Huang, the first emperor of China, Li's job was to transform vision into reality. Of all the beasts that roamed the earth, only men possessed this great and unique power, the power to manifest the ethereal into the corporeal. But not all men had the will, only great men, divine men, men such as himself. The creation of the world's greatest empire, governed under singular rule and law, was proof of his greatness as chancellor. He and he alone was the architect of this momentous feat, and he had accomplished it through unification and punishment. Li glared at a pile of horse dung on the footpath and sidestepped the offensive mass. This sort of filth was unacceptable inside the emperor's necropolis. The necropolis complex, although still under construction, was a sacred place and should be maintained as such. He filed the infraction away in his mind. Someone would be disciplined. He would see to that. As he made his way east to the standing terracotta army, he could not help but marvel at the magnificence around him. The necropolis of Qin Shi Huang was the largest construction project in all of China. Hundreds of thousands of laborers and craftsmen had been conscripted for the task. The necropolis was a microcosm of the empire, complete with an imperial palace, map room, and tomb mound at the center. It was designed to embody all aspects of daily imperial life and provide the emperor with everything he would need to rule in the afterlife. Unlike his forebearers, who upon death demanded burial sacrifice of their attending staff, Qin Shi Huang had chosen to construct a legion of life-sized terracotta doppelgangers to stand in for his host of advisors, servants, and soldiers. This shift in burial policy was Li's doing. He had no intention of sacrificing his life for a man he intended to outlive. He had already begun making plans and alliances, secretly selecting Qin Shi Huang's successor to ensure he would remain the chancellor when the emperor died. He had worked too hard the last 20 years to let something as mundane as death rob him of power. Craftsmen and laborers bowed their heads as Li strode along the outer wall, but he paid them no mind. The necropolis had two walls, an inner and outer, encircling the tomb mound. Inside the inner wall, statues of bureaucrats, courtiers, and advisors were staged, ready to serve the emperor in the afterlife. Bronze chariots and horses, with drivers and guards, waited ready to transport and protect the emperor wherever he might choose to go in the great beyond. Between the inner and outer walls, terracotta entertainers, artisans, and strongmen engaged in their craft, immortal spectacle for Qin Shi Huang. The imperial stables were located outside the outer wall. The emperor had decreed that real horses would be buried with terracotta grooms ready to service them in the immortal life. But the most impressive element of the emperor's mausoleum did not reside inside the necropolis. To the east, Li could just make out the columns of the terracotta army in the distance. Over 6,000 life-size warriors were already completed, each soldier painstakingly handcrafted and unique. No two warriors in the emperor's legion were the same. He picked up his pace, driven by compulsion. Every day he searched their faces. Every day he returned, unsatisfied. 10 minutes later, he was among the ranks, scanning their painted clay faces for his own. He had forbade the master craftsman from using his countenance, but his unsettled heart told him that somewhere in this clay army, there was a soldier wearing his face. He would find it, and when he did, he would have the statue destroyed. The afterlife was a fool's fantasy. Li was certain of this, which is why he had devoted all of his energy and faculties to accumulating as much power and pleasure in life as possible. Death is not transcendence, he told himself, and yet still he searched.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.